Alright, so now we'll take up compound interest. Compound interest is just another way of calculation of interest. We have already seen and discussed questions on simple interest. Now let's take a look at compound interest. What does it mean? In simple interest, the interest value for a year was always constant. Whereas in compound interest, the interest value is not constant. So first let's look at the process. What happens? Let's assume that the principal amount is 100 rupees. And let's say the rate is 10%. To understand, I'm taking an example. I'm starting with an example. Rate is 10% compounded annually. So let's try and understand what the meaning of this. Compounded annually, it means interest is calculated after every 1 year. And compounded means it is added to the principal amount. Let's try to understand it. Initially, principal amount is 100 rupees. In the first year, what will happen? In the first year, 10% interest is calculated on this 100 rupees and it is added. So what is 10% of 100 rupees? That is 10 rupees. Now what is this 10 rupees called? It is the compound interest for the first year. Right? So 100 rupees is the principal amount, rate is 10%. So during the first year, interest is calculated on 100 rupees, 10% of 100 rupees, that is 10 rupees. This 10 rupee is the interest value for the first year. I'll write it compound interest value for the first year. Right? Now this 10 rupees added to 100. So the amount becomes 110 rupees after 1 year. Now what will happen during the second year? During the second year, again 10% interest is calculated. But on which one? This second 10% is calculated on the new value, 110 rupees. Right? So whatever amount we get after 1 year, it becomes principal for the next year. So 10% of 110, now it is 11 rupees. What will you call this 11 rupees? This 11 rupees is the compound interest for the second year, CI2. I'm saying it is compound interest value for, please pay attention here, it's a very important concept. You know, so this 10 rupee was the interest for the first year. 11 rupee is the interest only for the second year. The compound interest value only for the second year. Alright. Now this 11 will get added to this 110. So this 10 was added to 100. This 11 will get added to 110. 110 plus 11 becomes 121. Now for the third year, what will happen? This 121 will become the principal amount. Again 10% will be calculated. 10% of 121 will be 12.1. This 12.1 rupees will be called compound interest for the third year and so on. So this will go on like this. So every time the 10% or the R percent is calculated on that, the principal value at that time. Right? And the interest is added. Whereas if you remember, in case of simple interest, what happened in case of simple interest? This whole thing was for compound interest. Now just to show, I'll help you to recall for simple interest, what happened in case of simple interest? If I take principal to be the same 100 rupees, if I take the rate to be same as 10%, what will happen? First year, the interest will be 10%, but 10% of what? 100 rupees. That is 10 rupees. So SI1, the simple interest for the first year, is going to be 10 rupees only. Right? This 10 rupees is added to 100, so it becomes 110 rupees. But in the second year, we don't have to calculate on this one because once we get the interest value for 1 year is 10 rupees, for simple interest, it is going to be constant. So without any calculation, SI2 is going to be 10 rupees. Without any calculation, SI3 is going to be 10 rupees and so on. So in simple interest, the calculation is a little simpler because the interest value, if you have calculated for first year, it is going to be the same for second year, going to be the same for the third year and so on. Whereas in compound interest, because the principal keeps changing, you know, so this 100 rupees was the principal amount initially. 110 rupees, let's call it principal amount after 1 year. P1, that is principal after 1 year. Principal after 1 year. Similarly, this 121 rupee, let's call this P2. It is principal after 2 years. principal after 2 years. Please be very careful about the terms that we are using here, right? So P1, P2, P3, these are the principals after 1 year, 2 year respectively. CI1 is the interest for only the first year. CI2 is the interest only for the second year. CI3 is the interest only for the third year, for second year, right? CI3 is the interest only for the compound interest value for the third year, only the third year, right? So as you can see, the interest value, the compound interest values are not constant. Okay, now there are some observations that you can have before creating a formula. We'll have a formula also for this, but before creating a formula, let's see what happens here. Let's make some points. For compound interest, the amounts, look at the amounts. Initial amount is P. After 1 year, the amount is P1. After 2 years, the amount is P2. In this case, principal is 100, rate is 10%. After 1 year, the amount becomes 110. After 2 years, the amount becomes 121. You see that these amounts are just increasing by R percent, right? So 100, it increases by R percent, or 10% in this case, it becomes 110. 110 increases by 10% or R percent becomes 121, and so on and so forth. So we can safely say that the amount simply increases by R percent every year. Increases by R percent every year. So for example, if I have, let's say, the amount after n years is Pm, and after n plus 1 years is Pn plus 1, the amounts after 2 consecutive years, one thing is for sure, that from here to here, from Pn to Pn plus 1, the increment would be of simply R percent. So R percent of Pn, if you add, you will always get Pn plus 1. I can also write it like this. Pn plus 1 will always be equal to Pn. Principal amount or the amount after n plus 1 years is simply equal to principal amount after n years plus R percent of principal amount after n years. This you can directly apply. You don't have to write this like this. I'm simply saying that any year, 2 consecutive years, if the amounts are given, you can directly find the rate. Whatever percentage change has happened from this value to this value will be the rate value. That is the very first understanding. Now look at the second thing. Now, from here, there is one observation. Look at the ratio of P and P1. In this case, it is 100 and 110. So it is 100 upon 110 cancel. We get 10 upon 11. 0 cancels 10 upon 11. Look at P1 upon P2. P1 is 110, P2 is 121. 11, 10 times, and 11, 11 times. So it is again 10 by 11. So what does it mean? These two ratios are equal. Oh. So whatever is the rate, that doesn't matter. The rate has to be the same everywhere. So the ratio of two consecutive values will be constant, or we can also say that the amounts are in proportion. So one observation is that the amount simply increases by R percent every year. And the second thing is, the amounts are in proportion. So you can directly memorize these properties, and there will be questions asked directly on them. Now what does it mean? It means P upon P1 is equal to P1 upon P2 is equal to P2 upon P3 is equal to, and so on, is equal to Pn upon Pn plus 1. So as long as you keep the gap as constant, here the gap between P and P1 is 1 year. P1 and P2 is 1 year. P2 and P3 is 1 year. So as long as the gap is same, the ratio is going to be constant. Similarly, suppose if I take the gap as 2 years, so P upon P2. This will be equal to P1 upon P3. This will be equal to P2 upon P4. This will be equal to P3 upon P5, and so on. So as long as the gap is same, the ratio is going to be constant. So this is one very important property of amounts in case of compound interest, right? So if the gaps are constant, say for example, if I take P upon P3, this will be equal to P3 upon P6. This will be equal to P4 upon P7. So any two amounts which have a 3 year gap, will be, the ratio will remain same, and so on and so forth. Right? So this is one very important observation for compound interest for amounts, right? Now let's look at the interest values also. Look at the interest values very carefully. What is the interest value for the first year? You know, all this we are doing before going into the formula, right? So understand this very carefully. What is the compound interest in the first year? It is 10 rupees. CI1 is 10 rupees. What is the compound interest in the second year? That is 11 rupees. See, understand, it is only the second year compound interest. What is the compound interest in the third year? It is 12.1 rupees. If you notice, what is the value increment from 10 to 11? 1 rupee, right? Now, what is 1 rupee as a percentage of 10 rupee? I just want to find what is the percentage change from 10 to 11. So, final minus initial is 1 rupee. So, the change, percentage change is in this case equal to 1 divided by original value 10 into 100, which is effectively 10%. Right. From here to here also, you see, on 11, if you increase by 10%, you will get 12.1. You know, 10% of 11 is 1.1. So, if you add 1.1 to 11, you will get 12.1. Right. What does it mean? It means the compound interest also increased by the same rate. Right. The amounts were increasing by R percent. The compound interest for the individual years or for the consecutive years, they will also increase at the same rate. Right. So very carefully, I'll make the note here. I'll remove this and I'll make the note here. The values of compound interest for individual years increase by R percent every year. Right? So, for example, if I have the compound interest for the nth year, compound interest for nth year, not n years, please be careful, it is not for n years, it is the nth year. And if I have a compound interest value for n plus 1th year, compound interest for n plus 1th year, what will happen? Simply, the percentage change from this value to this value will be R percent. So the way it happened for amounts, same thing will happen for compound interest values also. Now this means that here also the ratio will remain constant, and that you can check from the values also. We have CI1, the compound interest values for individual years are also in proportion. Okay, that means CI1 upon CI2 is equal to CI2 upon CI3 is equal to CI3 upon CI4. So as long as I keep the gap constant, the ratio will remain constant. Right? So these are the two properties directly applicable for situation of compound interest. One property is for amounts at the end of the periods. And one property is related to the compound interest value of the individual years. The properties are same in both the cases. The amounts increase by R percent every year. The compound interest values increase by R percent every year. The amount at the ends of the years are in proportion. The compound interest of individual years are in proportion. So the properties are exactly the same. A very beautiful situation. Now let's get into the formula of this situation. Let's try and understand how the formula is formed. If I say principal amount is P, if it increases by R percent, how much will it become? Let's see. After first year, it will become P plus R percent of P. Now this becomes P plus R by 100 or R by 100 into P. So if you take out P common, it will be P into 1 plus R by 100. Let's say this value is P1. Alright. Now in the second year, what will happen? In the second year, again there will be an increment of R percent, but this will be on P1. So this amount after 2 years will become P1 plus R percent of P1. If you simplify, it will again come out to be P1 plus R by 100 into P1. If you take out P1 common, it will be P1 into 1 plus R by 100. But P1 itself was this value. This is P1. So if you put it here, it will be P into 1 plus R by 100. So in place of P1, we have this item into this item, that is 1 plus R by 100. So what is happening? It is P into 1 plus R by 100 whole square. Oh, so after 1 year, it was P into 1 plus R by 100. After 2 years, it is P into 1 plus R by 100 square. Oh, so that means after N years, so we can say that the amount after N years is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N. See, after 1 year it was just power 1, after 2 years it is power 2, for 3 years it will be power 3, and so on and so forth. So after N years, the amount is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N. So please understand that in compound interest case, you can directly find the amount. And then to find compound interest, what will you have to do? To find compound interest, you will have to subtract principal amount from the amount. So it is A minus P. So it will be a two-step process always, right? Here we are assuming that it is compounded annually. I'll give you the other situations also. First, let's complete this. Compounded annually, all right? So compound interest will be amount minus the principal amount. So this is the formula that we have to use in some cases. Don't worry about the difficulty of this formula, because there are very few questions which will actually require this particular calculation. Let's take some questions to understand this formula, right? Now let's take the first question. It says, find compound interest on rupees 50,000 at the rate 20% for 2 years compounded annually, right? So first, what we'll do, we have P equal to 50,000, R equal to 20%, and N is the number of years, it is number of periods. Now here, one period is of 1 year, because compounded annually means one period is of 1 year. So N is equal to 2, because it is 2 years. So first we calculate amount, that is A, which is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N. So it is equal to 50,000 into 1 plus 20 by 100 to the power 2. Now 20 by 100 is 0.2, 1 plus 0.2 is 1.2, so it is 50,000 into 1.2 whole square. 1.2 square will be, 12 square is 144, so 1.2 square will be 1.44, so it is 50,000 into 1.44. So either you can calculate this, or you can directly calculate compound interest. In any case, this value is going to be, if you multiply, it will come out to be 72,000, right? So the final amount is 72,000, original amount is 50,000, principal amount. So the compound interest value is A minus P, which is 72,000 minus 50,000, that is 22,000. So the answer of the question is 22,000, right? So here, in this question, the direct formula is more useful to us. If we use the stepwise process, as I have explained earlier, let's look at that also as just another way to look at it. If I say principal amount, which is 50,000, what happens during the first year? I'm using the very fundamental process of calculation of compound interest. In the first year, 20% will be calculated on the principal amount, that is 50,000. And that will give us the compound interest for only the first year. So it will be 20% of 50,000. If you calculate 20% of 50,000, 20% is 20 by 100, there is 1 by 5, that is 10,000 rupees. So compound interest for the first year, only the first year, is 10,000 rupees, right? Now there are two ways again. Either you can add this to 50,000, it becomes 60,000 rupees. First year interest is added to principal amount. So this gives us 60,000 rupees. This 60,000 becomes the principal amount after 1 year, and during the second year you have to calculate again 20%, but on 60,000. Now 20% of 60,000, that will give us the compound interest for the second year, which will be 20% of 60,000, that is 12,000 rupees, that is CI2, Or you could have directly calculated from here. We have seen that the compound interest also, compound interest for individual years, that also increases by R percent. So we could have directly calculated from here to here. First year interest is 10,000. So if I add 20% to this, I must get second year interest. If I add 20% to this, I must get, you know, third year interest, and so on and so forth. Here we don't need to do that. But in any case, the compound interest for the first year, 10,000. Compound interest for the second year, 12,000. So total 2 years compound interest will be equal to CI1 plus CI2, and that will be equal to 10,000 plus 12,000, that is equal to 22,000. So this was another way of doing it, right? But in any case, I just wanted to show you that this is one very important method. In some other questions, we will be using this method because we are going to encounter more complicated situations also. So here the answer of the question is 22,000. Or there is another thing that you could have done. Add this 12,000 to 60,000, it becomes 72,000. This is the final amount after 2 years. Whatever is the difference of final amount and the initial amount, that has to be 2 years compound interest, and that will be equal to 22,000. So this was another way of looking at it. Right? So either you use the formula and you calculate from there, or you calculate individual years compound interest, or you calculate the final amount one by one and then find the interest of the total compound interest of 2 years. Right? So in any case, this is how it is going to be. Okay. Now let's take some more situations on this formula first. Now this question says, find compound interest on 40,000 rupees at the rate 20% for 2 years compounded semi-annual. Let's try and understand this first. I'll only use the formula in this question. If I say P is equal to rupees 40,000, rate is equal to 20%. Perfect. Right? See, understand, the rate is always the given rate. Now, what about N? Right? Now, N is not 2 years here, because here the interest is compounded semi-annually. This means, now semi-annual means half year, 6 months. In this case, the interest is going to be added every time after 6 months, after half year. So, in a period of 2 years, how many half years are going to be? In a period of 2 years, how many half years? So in 1 year, there are 2 half years. So in 2 years, there will be 4 half years. So remember, N is the total number of periods. And the number of periods will be calculated on the basis of how it is being compounded. So if it is compounded annually, N is equal to number of years. If it is compounded semi-annually, N is going to be 2 times the number of years. Okay, if it is going to be quarterly, then the number of periods will be 4 times, because in every 1 year there will be 4 quarters. All right, so in this case, N is equal to 4. Now, what about this R? We are again and again saying this is always for 1 year, whereas in this case our period is semi-annual. So instead of taking 20%, we'll take half of 20% in place of R in our formula, that is 10%. So for this question, we will not take 20% as R, we will take 10% as R. Because always remember, this particular R is rate for a period. Always remember this. See, when it was annually, there was no problem at all. The rate for the period was the rate for the year. But when it is semi-annual, we have to understand that it will be rate for the semi-annual. For 1 year, it is 20%. For a semi-year, it will be 10%. So now, our A will be equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N, which is P is 40,000. 1 plus, in place of this R, we will not take 20, we will take 10%. So 10 divided by 100. In place of N, we will take 4. So this becomes 40,000 into 10 by 100 is 1.1, 1 plus 0.1, so 1.1 to the power 4. Now, obviously, this calculation is going to be a little tricky. So, it is 40,000 into 1.1 square is 1.21, and square of that is 1.4641. And hence, this method becomes a little difficult in some cases. You know, when the power is high, it will automatically always be difficult. Don't worry too much about it. There will be only a couple of questions for practice given in the book. That's it. So, I'm not going to calculate this. Because our question is compound interest. So the required compound interest will be equal to, we know that the compound interest is A minus P. Here the amount is 40,000 into 1.4641 minus P is 40,000. So what happens if you take out 40,000 common? It will give us 1.4641 minus 1, which is 40,000 into 0.4641. If you calculate, this will give you the answer. Right? So it is 4 ones are 4, 16, 5, 2, 18. So it is 18,564 rupees. This is the compound interest in this particular case. Right? So just remember, if it is semi-annual, number of periods will become double of number of years. If it is quarterly, number of periods will become 4 times the number of years. If it is every 4 months, then the number of periods will become 3 times the number of years, and so on and so forth. Also, be careful, the rate will also change. The value of R to be put in formula will also change. Right? So if it is semi-annual, it will become 20 by 4. If it was 20 by 2. If it was quarterly, it will become 20 by 4, that is 5%. If it was every 4 months, that means 20 by 3 will be the R in this case, and so on and so forth. Okay, now let's take some more questions here. Now this question says an amount changes from 1000 to 1331 rupees in 3 years. Find rate of compound interest. So in this case, it is already given a compound interest compounded annually. Right? So here it is already given that it is compounded annually. That is important to be given because we need to know the number of periods, whether it is equal to number of years or not. So here P is given as 1000 rupees, A is given as 1331 rupees, R we have to calculate, right, and N is given as 3. Why? Because annual and 3 years, so N is straight away equal to 3. We can directly apply the formula A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N. A is 1331, P is 1000, 1 plus R by 100 to the power 3. Now 1331 upon 1000 is equal to 1 plus R by 100 to the power 3. Whenever such questions are asked, usually values given are known values. Now in this case, if you look at it closely, 1331 is 11 cube, alright, and 1000 is 10 cube. So 11 cube upon 10 cube is equal to 1 plus R by 100 whole cube. So whole cube goes away and we get 11 by 10 equal to 1 plus R by 100. But yes, you can do this question only if you remember this, because otherwise it will be really difficult to solve. So R by 100 is equal to 11 by 10 minus 1, that is 1 by 10. From there, we have R by 100 equal to 1 by 10. So R is equal to 100 by 10, that is 10%. So the answer of this question is 10%. All right. But this question requires you to memorize the 11 cube is 1331. Just by looking at it, if you are able to use this particular thing, you will be able to solve. Otherwise, it is going to be difficult. Okay. Now, let's take. But these questions are not asked for very high, very long period. The maximum is 3 years. Most of your questions will be related to 2 years, which is very easy. We'll look at all situations of 2 years. Okay. Now, let's take some more questions. Now this question says an amount doubles in 5 years at compound interest. In how many years will it become 8 times? An amount doubles in 5 years at compound interest. How many years will it become 8 times? Right? Let's see. In compound interest, we have seen that the amounts are in the same ratio if taken at the same gap. Right? So P upon P1 is equal to P1 upon P2 is equal to P2 upon P3 and so on and so forth. This thing can be directly applied here. Here we are saying that suppose initial amount is P, after 5 years, let's say the amount is P5, and it's given that P5 is equal to 2P. So in fact, let me put it this way, it is 2P, after 5 years it is 2P, right? Now when the ratio is constant, what does it mean? The same, it is going to be multiplied by the same number. Here the ratio is 2 is to 1, or we can also see that it is P multiplied by 2 is gets 2P. In simple interest, we used to work with the difference. This is compound interest. In this case, in the same duration, the ratio of two values is going to be constant. What does it mean? If from P to 2P, that has taken 5 years, then in the next 5 years, what is going to happen? we can again multiply by 2. So 2p into 2, that will become 4p. So this is simpler than simple interest question. Again, after 5 years, what will happen? We can directly multiply by 2, so it becomes 8p. And I think this is where we have to reach. The question is asking how many years will it become? 8 times. So from p to 8p, if you calculate the total number of years is 5 plus 5 plus 5, which is 15 years. So this was a much simpler question. We are using this property, though it is much simpler than that also. If the amount is getting twice, or if it is getting multiplied by 2 in 5 years, then in every 5 years it will keep on getting multiplied by 2. Why? Because if I say this is p, this is p5, this is p10, this is p15, then p upon p5 has to be p5 upon p10. Alright, it has to be p10 upon p15. It has to be p15 upon p20, and so on and so forth. Why? As long as we take the same gap, the ratio is going to be constant. Now, p upon p5, we already know it is given as 1 by 2. So, p5 upon p10 will also be 1 by 2. p10 upon p15 will also be 1 by 2. So, every 5 years, the amount will keep getting doubled. So, answer to this question is 15 years. You just had to check how many times does it take 5 years to complete or to get to 8 times the original value. Let's take another question on this. Now, in this question, it says an amount triples in 6 years compound interest. In how many years will it become 81 times. In how many years will it become 81 times, right? Now, in this question, what do we do? Let's say P is the initial amount. After 6 years, it becomes 3P. That means it has become 3 times, right? Because it is tripling after 6 years, okay? Now, what we have learned here, in the same gap, it is going to be multiplied by the same number. So in 6 years, it is being multiplied by 3. So in the next 6 years, it is again going to be multiplied by 3, and this value multiplied by 3. So it becomes 3 threes are 90. Again 6 years, it is again going to be multiplied by 3. So it becomes 27p. And again 6 years, it is going to be multiplied by 3. So 27 into 3 is 81p. So from p to 81p, it is 4 times 6 years, right? Please understand, it is a different thing. It is compound interest situation that we are doing now, alright? So it becomes 4 times 6 years, that is 24 years. So this will happen in 24 years, okay? So this is an easier situation. Compound interest case is an easier situation, alright? So this is one beautiful case that we have done, okay? Let's take a couple of more questions on the fundamental properties first. Now, this question says an amount becomes rupees 12,000 after 3 years and rupees 18,000 after 6 years at compound interest. Find principal amount. Alright, so let's say the principal amount is P. After 3 years, the amount should be P3. After 6 years, the amount should be P6. I hope you can see that the gap from P to P3 is 3 years. From P3 to P6 is also 3 years. So if the gap is the same, we can apply this property that the ratios are going to be constant, right? So that means P upon P3 should be equal to P3 upon P6. See, the only thing that you need to check is whether the periods are same or not. If the amounts are at the same gap, same period, the ratios will remain constant. And in your questions, it is bound to happen like that, because otherwise it will become too lengthy for a calculation. You will not be asked such questions. You will be asked only this type of questions where the gaps are same. Here P3 is already given, that is 12,000 rupees. P6 is already given 18,000 rupees. Just put them there, find the value of P. Alright, so it is P divided by 12,000 equal to 12,000 divided by 18,000. Wow. So 18,000, 0, 0 cancel. 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18. 3 cancel 12,000, 4,000. So P is equal to 4,000 into 2. This goes to the other side. So 4,000 into 2 is 8,000 rupees. That means the principal amount in this case is 8,000, right? So that is our answer of the question. I will add one more thing. Also find amount after 9 years. Let's see if we can do that. What will happen? P6 to P9, it is 3 years more. That means this P upon P3 is equal to P3 upon P6 is equal to P6 upon P9. Right? So here P3 upon P6 is already 2 by 3, right? P3 upon P6, we can use this one and we can calculate the value of P9 like this. P3 is 12,000, P6 is 18,000, is equal to P6 is 18,000 divided by P9. So we can calculate P9 from here. Let's see. 6 3s are 18, 6 2s are 12, 2 cancels 18, 9,000. So P9 cross multiplication will give us 3 into 9,000, that is 27,000. So as long as the amounts are at the same gap, right, you can directly apply the ratio method or this formula for this. Alright, so here the gaps are 3 years, 3 years, 3 years. As long as is there any other question, let's say if it is find the amount after 12 years, you can go on doing that. It'll be difficult to calculate amount after 8 years or 7 years or 4 years, but you will not be asked those questions. Remember that. Okay, that's it. So this is how these questions are really, really beautiful. Now let's take this question. It says an amount becomes rupees 4,000 after 3 years and rupees 5,000 after 4 years at compound interest. Find rate of annual compound interest. If you remember, we have done it in the very beginning of compound interest, that the amounts also increase at the same rate. Do you remember that? Let's say I had given you a rule that for nth year if the amount is p and for n plus 1th year if the amount is n plus 1, p n plus 1, then from year to year the change has to be r percent, right? So in this case I am given with the amount after 3 years, so that is p3, and amount are given after 4 years, so consecutive years. That means the increment has to be r percent from here to here. So whatever percentage change has happened from P3 to P4 has to be the rate of interest. Alright, so this question will always be asked for 2 consecutive years. You read the question carefully. It must say the amount becomes so and so and so and so. So here P3 is 4,000, amount after 3 years is 4,000 rupees, amount after 4 years is 5,000 rupees. So what is the value change? The value change is 1,000 rupees. You have to calculate what percentage of 4,000 is this 1,000, right? So rate percentage is equal to 1,000 divided by 4,000 into 100. Always remember, you can do this only if there is a gap of 1 year, right? Only if the amounts given for are given for consecutive years. So it becomes 1 by 4 into 100, that is 25%, right? Again, you will be asked only such situations where, you know, it's like 6 years and 7 years or 8 years and 9 years. In any case, whatever is the situation, it has to be 2 consecutive years. Then directly, whatever is the percentage change from the lower year to the higher year, right? If the gap is of 1 year, the percentage change is the rate percent. You have to directly memorize this. Alright? Now let's take another question on this. Now, this question says the compound interest for the 5th year is 600 rupees and for the 6th year is 680 rupees. The way we have rule for principal amounts, similarly we have the rule for compound interest values also. If we are given with the nth year compound interest and CI n plus 1, n plus 1th year compound interest, again we can say that whatever is the percentage change from year to year is r percent. Right, so compound interest also increase at the same rate, right? So here it is given that CI 5 is 600 rupees. Please understand, it is the interest only for the 5th year. It is not the interest for 5 years, okay? CI 6, that is interest for the 6th year, that is given as 680 rupees. So I repeat, whatever is the percentage change from here to here, it is R percent, it is the rate percent, right? And we have to find the rate. Okay, so directly apply this. What is the value change? It is 680 minus 69, that is 80 rupees is the value change. So the percentage change is equal to the R percent value, and it will be equal to the value change divided by initial value 600. We have to calculate what percentage of 600 is 80. So 80 upon 600 into 100. Right? So if you simplify, 0, 0 cancels, it is 40 by 3%. 40 by 3% is actually 13 1 by 3% or 13.33%. Look at the options, whichever is there, you have to mark. Right? So this was one very beautiful direct application. I repeat, if the compound interest value for consecutive years, only for those years are given, this will be the situation. You can directly find the percentage change from 1 year interest with second year interest to the next year interest. That percentage change will be the rate percentage. All right. I'll make this question a little more complicated. Let's take another one. Now, look at this question. This is a very tricky situation. It says the compound interest for the first 3 years is 480 rupees. For the entire first 3 years. So it is not the compound interest for the third year. It is total 3 years, right? Compound interest for the first 4 years is rupees 520. So in the total period of 4 years, the compound interest is 520. So in this language, if I want to put it, then this 480 is actually first year compound interest plus second year compound interest plus third year compound interest. This 520 is equal to first year compound interest plus second year compound interest plus third year compound interest plus fourth year compound interest. And similarly, this 568 is the total interest for 5 years. So 568 is equal to compound interest for the first year, compound interest for the second year, compound interest for the third year, compound interest for the fourth year, and compound interest for the fifth year. Please try and understand. Just to make sure that you understand it very clearly, I have written all this. We don't need to write this. You know, this much logic we can directly apply. Okay, now let's see. Here, first 3 year interest is 480. So here also the first 3 year interest is going to be 480. So the fourth year interest, I'll put it like this, CI4 will be 520 minus 480. We can put 480 here. So it is 520 minus 480, which is equal to 40 rupees. So we have fourth year interest as 40 rupees. Now, if you look at this, first 4 year interest is 520, and that means here also the first 4 year interest will be 520. So if you put it here, we'll get CI5, that is only the fifth year interest, and that will be 568 minus 520. So 568 minus 520, that is equal to 48 rupees. Oh, so that means we have got the compound interest value for consecutive individual years. So fourth year compound interest is 40 rupees. Fifth year compound interest is 48 rupees. Whatever is the percentage change from 40 to 48 has to be the rate percentage, right? What is the value change from 40 to 48? It is 8 rupees. 8 over 40 is the rate. So rate percentage will be equal to 8 divided by 40 into 100, right? That is a normal percentage situation. So 8 cancels 40 5 times, 5 cancels 100 20 times. So it is 20% is the rate in this case. So this was a really good question. All right. Now let's go ahead to the next topic or next part. Let's take one more question before we end this segment. Suppose the question says that if an amount doubles in 5 years at compound interest, find rate. Now, earlier we had done such questions for simple interest. Now, this is the situation of compound interest. Now, look at this very carefully. For compound interest, we do not need to go into the details for such situation. So, the way we have created a formula for simple interest, similarly, we will create a formula for compound interest also. Look at this very, very carefully. All right. So, I'll make it like this. In case of compound interest, if amount doubles, you can simply memorize that rate into time is approximately equal to 72. This is called rule of 72. In case of simple interest, we had r into t, rate into time equal to 100. In case of compound interest, it is r into t approximately equal to 72. This is called rule of 72. You just have to understand that this rule of 72 is applicable only for compound interest and only in the case where amount doubles. And also, it is not a perfect rule, it is approximate rule. And one important thing, this T is actually the number of periods. Just be careful about this. Number of periods. Alright, so I'll rewrite it. It is R into N, that is equal to 72, and it is approximately equal to. Alright, so now in this question, let's see. If an amount doubles in 5 years at compound interest, find rate, and nothing is mentioned, so we'll take it by default compounded annually, right? Usually it is mentioned, I'll mention it here, compounded annually, all right? So directly what you can do, rate into
number of years has to be approximately equal to 72, right? So here number of years is given as 5, so n is equal to 5. So you can say that rate is approximately equal to 72 by 5, which is 14.4%. Now don't worry about the approximate value, because the nearest integer would be given in the options. Usually in such questions, in this particular question, the option which is 15% or 14% would be the correct answer. So 14 to 15% is the correct answer. All right. Let's take some more situations in this only. Suppose if I give you the rate and we say that case of amount doubling in compound interest, right? Suppose I say the rate is 20%, then in how many years will it double itself at compound interest? We know that R into T has to be approximately equal to 72. Alright, and if rate is given 20%, the time will be equal to 72 divided by R. So it is, in this case, for 20%, it will be 72 divided by 20. Now this is a tricky situation. Look at this very carefully. 72 by 20 is 3.6, but the answer will not be 3.6 years. You always have to take the higher value, the upper value to 3.6, because the interest will be always be calculated at the end of the year. And also this rule was an approximate rule. So the correct answer will be the nearest year on the higher side of the value that you get. So here if your value is 3.6 years, the answer will be 4 years. Okay, so the amount will double in 4 years at the rate of 20%. Suppose the rate is 10%. In how many years will the amount double in compound interest case? Right, so it will be 72 divided by 10. This gives us 7.2. Now this means the answer will be 8 years. You always have to take the higher side value. Okay, when the time is asked, you always have to take the higher side value. Suppose we change it. Suppose the time is given and you have to find the rate. We'll apply the same formula. Rate is equal to approximately 72 by T. So if I say the time is 6 years, then what should be the rate for the amount to double in compound interest? It will be simply 72 divided by 6, which is approximately 12%. Remember, the answer option which is slightly more than 12 will be the correct answer. The options will be given in that manner only, so you don't have to worry about. The value closest to 12% will be the answer. The value closest to 12% will be the answer. Alright, so the higher than, our answer will be higher than 12 and closest to 12. Don't worry, in the options, there will be only one value which is higher to 12 and close to 12. Right. So this is where we have completed all the theoretical aspect of compound interest. Now let's go to the next part.
All right. Now we'll take the most important aspect of this chapter, that is comparison of compound interest and simple interest. There are a lot of direct questions asked on this, a small topic. Let's deal with it separately. Let's assume, obviously, it is when we say comparison of compound and simple interest, we'll say for same amount at same rate. So same amount and same rate, and we have to compare compound interest and simple interest for different durations. Let's see. First, I'll write the simple interest process. If you remember, what was the simple interest process? If I take P as the principal amount, first year, what is going to happen? R percent is going to be calculated on P. So simple interest for the first year is going to be R percent of P, which is R by 100 into P, that is PR by 100. So simple interest for the first year is PR by 100. So the amount becomes P plus PR by 100. What about the second year? In the second year, we don't need to do any calculation here, because we already know that simple interest every year is constant. This we have discussed a couple of times earlier also. So simple interest every year is constant. Now 1 year is PR upon 100. So every year the interest is going to be PR upon 100. So SI2, interest for the second year, is going to be PR upon 100. So the amount will become P plus. It was already P plus PR by 100 after 1 year. So again PR by 100 is added. So it becomes 2 PR upon 100. In the third year, it will become, after the third year, it will become P plus 3 PR by 100. Why? Because even in the third year, compound interest for simple interest for the third year is going to be PR upon 100 only. right? So this was the process for simple interest. Every year the interest value is going to be the same, right? So interest for each year is going to be PR upon 100. That is why for T years it becomes PRT upon 100, okay? Now let's look at the compound interest process. Okay, look at this very carefully. If I take principal amount as P, because we have to take the same amount and the same rate. Rate is R percent. Now what happens in the first year? Let's look at it very, very closely. In the first year, the compound interest for the first year is going to be R percent of P only, because R percent is going to be calculated on P only. So it is R percent of P, which is PR upon 100. Wow, so interesting. What does it mean? The simple interest and compound interest for the first year, they are the same. All right. So for first year, compound interest is equal to simple interest. Or rather, CI1 is equal to SI1. Wow, what a beautiful thing. So in the first year, the value of compound interest is equal to the value of simple interest. Very good. Now let's see. Now let's go ahead. So the amount becomes P plus PR upon 100. What happens in the second year? In the second year, again we have to calculate R percent. But this time is R percent on this new value, right? Because compound interest is not going to remain same. Or we can directly calculate the second year compound interest from here, because we know that compound interest also increases by R percent. So first year compound interest is PR by 100. So second year compound interest will be PR by 100 plus R percent of PR by 100. R percent of PR by 100. So if we calculate, it will become PR upon 100 plus R by 100 into PR. So it becomes PR square upon 100 square. Be very careful about this. Right? Oh, so that means the second year simple interest and the second year compound interest are not the same. All right, perfectly fine. But in any case, the first year simple interest and the first year compounded, they are same. From second year, there is going to be a difference. Can you see the difference value? PR by 100 is same as PR by 100. The difference value is only this much. Fantastic. Then similarly, third year, the complication will increase. So we will not go to third year. As I told you earlier, our questions will be primarily related to 2 years only. So what all do we have now? In the first year, compound interest is equal to the simple interest value. What about the second year? For second year, what is the difference between compound interest and simple interest? Can you see that? In the second year, what is the difference between compound interest and simple interest? You can see that CI2 minus SI2. I'm saying this whole value minus this value. How much is it? It is PR square upon 100 square. Fantastic. So first year, same compound interest and simple interest. Second year, the difference value is this much, PR square upon 100 square. Now, one very important thing. What is 2 years total simple interest? That is SI1 plus SI2. So PR upon 100 plus PR upon 100. So it is 2 PR upon 100. What is 2 years total compound interest? Look at this. Compound interest for the first year is PR upon 100. Compound interest for the second year is PR upon 100 plus PR square upon 100 square. So total 2 year compound interest will be this plus this. So it becomes 2 PR upon 100. Plus PR square upon 100 square. Please note this very, very carefully. Take your time. 2 years total simple interest is 2 times PR upon 100. 2 years total compound interest is 2 times PR upon 100 plus PR square upon 100 square. So finally, we are not going to do compound interest for 3 years because that is not asked generally. It will never be asked. You will be asked questions only on 2 years. Now look at this very, very carefully. I'm going to write something. For 2 years, what is the difference for 2 years, what is the difference between compound interest and simple interest on same sum at same rate? What will happen? You can see that for 2 years, total simple interest is 2 PR upon 100. Total compound interest is 2 PR 100 upon 100 plus PR square upon 100 square. So it is only PR square upon 100 square. Alright. So what all does it mean? Again, in the first year, no difference between compound interest and simple interest. In the second year, the difference is PR square upon 100 square. And for overall 2 years, obviously, whatever is the difference in the 2 years compounded and simple interest is only because of the second year, because the first year is same. Right. So this finally becomes a direct formula for us that for 2 years, I'll write it again. For 2 years, compound interest minus simple interest is directly equal to PR square upon 100 square. Right. So this is one direct formula which would be really, really useful for many questions. We'll take some questions. Okay. So I'll remove the other things and we'll take some questions now. You have to memorize that first year, compound interest and simple interest values are exactly the same. In the second year, there is a difference and that is PR square upon 100 square. Or the total difference of 2 years compound interest and simple interest is the same thing, that is PR square upon 100 square. Right. And every year the compound interest increases by R percent. So these are the basic theory that we are going to use. So let's take some more questions and see how it works. So I have written the summary again here. For first year on the same sum at the same rate, compound interest is equal to simple interest. I'll write here for same P and R. So same principal amount and same rate. The first year compound interest is equal to first year simple interest. From first year compound interest to second year compound interest, the increment has to be R percent, the rate percent. And for 2 years, the difference between compound interest and simple interest, total difference is PR square upon 100 square. You know, you have to memorize this formula. Now let's take up some questions. Okay. Find difference between compound interest and simple interest for 2 years on 5400 rupees at the rate 10%. At the rate 10%. Right. So as you can see, it is already given for 2 years. P is equal to 5400. R is equal to 10. That means our difference of compound interest and simple interest for 2 years, we can directly apply the formula L, that is PR square upon 100 square. Be careful in calculation. P is 5400. R is 10, so 10 square. Divide by 100 square. So it becomes 5400 into 10 square is 100. Divide by 100 square is 100 into 100. So 0, 0 cancel. These 0, 0s cancel. So it is 54 rupees. Right? So answer of this question is straight away 54 rupees. So beautiful. Alright, let's take some more questions. I'll just give you some more situations directly. Find, same question, find the difference between compound interest and, remember this question will always be asked only for 2 years, right? You will not be required to know for 3 years. Even if it is for 3 years, it is going, obviously if it is for 3 years, it will be a lengthy calculation. Hence in your exam, it doesn't make sense. Because your exams are mostly logic based and small calculations. Difference between compound interest and simple interest for 2 years on rupees 48,000 at 5%. Right? So straight away that required difference is equal to, we know the formula PR square upon 100 square. P is 48,000. R is 5, so 5 square upon 100 square. So we have 48,000 into 25 divided by 100 into 100. So 25 cancels 100 4 times, 2 zeros are cancelled and 4 cancels 480, 120 times. So final answer is 120 rupees. So this is how these questions can be done directly. Let's take a couple of more questions. All right. Now, this question, at what rate the difference between compounded and simple interest for 2 years on rupees 50,000 will be rupees 320? So, here already the difference is given. And that is for 2 years, we can directly apply the formula. See, to apply this formula, it is important that it is given for 2 years. So, for 2 years, it is PR square upon 100 square. Right? The difference is 320. P is 50,000. R square upon 100 square is 100 into 100. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros cancel. So, we have R square equal to 320 upon 5. If you cancel 320 by 5, you will get 64. Right, and 64 is 8 square. So the required rate is 8%. Right, so this is how these questions can be done with direct the help of the formula. Let's take one more situation. Alright, in this question it says on what sum the difference between compound interest and simple interest for 2 years is rupees 36 at the rate 4%. Again, a direct question. Difference, because it is for 2 years, we will apply the formula. Difference between compound and simple interest for 2 years formula is PR square upon 100 square. So difference is 36. P we have to calculate. R square is 4 square divided by 100 square. Right. So we have P equal to 36 into 100 square is 10,000. And 4 square is 16. Now 4 cancels 16 4 times and 36 9 times. 4 cancels 10,000 2500 times. So we have P is equal to 9 into 2500, which is 22,500. So the required principal amount in this case is 22,500 rupees. Alright, so these are some very good questions, beautiful questions on the basis of this formula. Let's take a couple of more situations. Now in this question, it says simple interest and compound interest on a certain sum for 2 years are 1500 rupees and 1560 rupees respectively. Find the principal amount and the rate of interest. Now, this is a very interesting situation. We can still go ahead and apply these formulas. How? Look at this. 2 years, simple interest is 1500. So, this means 1 year, simple interest will be 1500 by 2, which is 750. And 1 year, simple interest, we know it is PR upon 100. So, PR upon 100 is 750. Alright. Now, look at the 2 year simple interest is 1500, 2 year compound interest is 1560. So, what is the difference for 2 years? That compound interest minus simple interest, the difference between 2 years, between them for 2 years is 1560 minus 1500, which is 60. Now, for the difference of 2 years, we have a formula called PR square upon 100 square, and that is equal to 60. So, we have two equations. One is PR upon 100 equal to 750. And second is PR square upon 100 square is 60. Right? So this can be directly applied here. How? Let's see. We can write it like this. PR square upon 100 square is equal to 60. So we can write it as PR upon 100 into R upon 100. We are just breaking it. PR upon 100 upon 100 square. We can write it as PR upon 100 into R upon 100 is equal to 60. PR upon 100 from the first one is 750 into R upon 100. Equal to 60. Alright, so if you simplify, I think you can directly get your answer. R is equal to 60 into 100 divided by 750. So if you see 0 and 0 are cancelled, 25 4 times is 100, 25 3 times is 75, 3 cancels 6 2 times. So R is equal to 2 into 4, that is 8%. So the rate is 8%. And if I put the value of R here, that is PR upon 100 is 750, we will get the value of P. So it is P into 8 upon 100 equal to 750, right? So if you see, it is P equal to 750 upon 8. If you simplify, it will come out to be 9,375 rupees, alright? Okay, now this was one way of doing this question. Now we will use another. So this was the formula method. Now specially for this particular question and other questions, we need to learn another method for this. Okay, so I'll remove this, right? So I think we have done sufficient number of questions with the help of formula. Now let's take a different technique or method for such questions, right? For that, let me prepare a small chart. I'm saying simple interest and compound interest for first year, for second year and so on. Okay, be very particular, only first year, only second year. Right? What all do we know? What we know is CI1 to CI2, there has to be a change of R percent. We also know that the first year simple interest is going to be same as first year compound interest. Alright, now let's see. Here it is given that simple interest for 2 years is 1500. So total 2 year simple interest is 1500 and simple interest is going to be same every year. So each year it is going to be 750, 750. I repeat, total 2 year simple interest is 1500. So 1 year simple interest will be 750. Why? Because they are equally distributed. That every year the interest value, simple interest value has to be the same. So first year is 750 rupees, second year also 750 rupees, third year also the simple interest value is going to be 750 rupees and so on. And for the first year, simple interest value and compound interest value are same. So SI1 is equal to CI1. So we get simple interest value 750 rupees. So compound interest value for the first year is also 750 rupees. Right? Now, 2 year compound interest value is 1560. First year compound interest value is 750. So that means second year compound interest will be 1560 minus 750. That is 810 rupees. Right? So we have got all this calculation you could have done mentally also. So we have got 750 rupees as first year compound interest and 810 rupees as second year compound interest. Whatever is the percentage change from here to here has to be the rate. Right? So let's calculate the percentage change from 750 to 810. The value difference is 810 minus 750, that is 60. So the rate percentage will be 60 divided by 60 as a percentage of 750. So 60 by 750 into 100. So if you calculate 25 4s are 100, 25 3s are 75, 3 cancels 6, 2 times 2 into 4, 8%. So that means the required rate is 8%. And then you can go back. The first year simple interest, we already know it is PR upon 100. So PR upon 100 equal to 750, R is 8, so put here P into 8 upon 100. If you follow the same process of calculation, it will give us principal amount equal to 9375 rupees. Right? So this is one very beautiful method for such questions. Let's take more questions on the basis of this method. Just remember, if 2 year simple interest is given, then 1 year simple interest, but just by dividing by 2 you can calculate. First year, the value of simple interest and compound interest are going to be the same. 2 year compound interest is given. First year you have calculated, the second year we can calculate by subtraction. Then whatever is the percentage change from first year compound interest to second year compound interest has to be the rate. Once you calculate the rate from the first year, you can calculate the principal amount also. Alright, let's take some more questions. Okay, so now let's take up this question. The simple interest on a certain sum for 3 years is rupees 360 and compound interest for 2 years on the same sum at the same rate is 270 rupees. Find principal amount and rate of interest. Alright. Let's see. We'll just prepare the simple chart, simple interest and compound interest. First year, second year, for that matter in this case third year also. Because 3 year simple interest is given as 360. So 1 year will be 360 by 3. So every year it will be 120 rupees. 120 rupees. So simple interest for every year is going to be 120 rupees. Now first year simple interest and first year compound interest are going to be the same. So first year compound interest is 120 rupees. Total 2 year compound interest is 270. Total 2 year compound interest is 270. Out of that, first year is 120. So the second year compound interest is 270 minus 120, which is 150 rupees. So first year compound interest 120 rupees, second year compound interest 150 rupees. What is the percentage change from here to here? Just calculate. So the value change is 30 on 120 into 100. So the rate percentage is equal to 30 by 120 is 1 by 4, 100 by 4 is 25%. So the rate is straight away 25%. And the first year interest is always PR upon 100. So from here you can, by putting the value of R, you can calculate P also. So PR upon 100 is equal to 120, R is 25. So P into 25 by 100 equal to 120. 25 4 times, so P equal to 120 into 4, that is 480 rupees. Right? So this is how these questions become really, really easy. Let's take one more question. Okay, now let's take this question. It says the ratio of compound interest and simple interest for 2 years, obviously on the same sum at the same rate, is 21:20. Find rate. Now how do we do this? Let's see. So here we are saying that the compound interest upon simple interest, that is 21/20. Let's assume that it is 21 rupees and this is 20 rupees and we follow the same procedure, right? So I say simple interest, compound interest, first year, second year. Simple interest we have taken as 20 rupees for 2 years. This ratio is given for 2 years. So this 20 is the 2 year simple interest. So for every year, the simple interest will become half of 20, that is 10 rupees and 10 rupees. 2 year simple interest is 20 rupees. So for 1 year, it will be 10 rupees. That means compound interest for the first year is also going to be 10 rupees because first year, they are same. And 2 years compound interest from here is 21. First year is 10. So second year compound interest will be 21 - 10, that is 11 rupees. Right? Now, first year compound interest, 10 rupees. Second year compound interest, 11 rupees. Whatever is the percentage change is R percent. Alright. So see, from 10 to 11, it is 1 by 10 into 100. That is the percentage change. So rate is equal to 1 by 10 into 100, that is 10%. Right? So even if you change the ratio, you can still go ahead and calculate. So for example, if I give you a different ratio in the same question, if I take different ratios like this, say if ratio was 11:10, then what will be the rate? Alright, let's do this. So simple interest, 10 is the 2 years simple interest. It's the same question, I am changing the ratio. Let's say this is A, this is B. So for the same situation, 2 year simple interest is 10. So first year simple interest can be taken as 5. Second year simple interest can be taken as 5. Right? Compound interest, first year is going to be the same 5. And here 2 year compound interest is 11. First year compound interest is 5. So second year will be 11 - 5, that is 6. From 5 to 6, whatever is the percentage change is R percent. So R is equal to 5 to 6 is 1 divided by original value 5 into 100. So 5 into 100, 20 times, so it is R is equal to 20%. Let's take another one. Suppose it says C, if, same question, if ratio is, let's say, 6:5, compound interest, simple interest for 2 years. Again, same thing, so simple interest. 2 years is 5 rupees, so first year it will be half of that, 2.5, second year it will also be 2.5, right? That means compound interest, what will happen? First year it is going to be same as simple interest, second year it will be, 2 year compound interest is 6, first year 2.5, so second year compound interest is 6 - 2.5, which is 3.5. Percentage change from 2.5 to 3.5 will be R percent, so it is 1 divided by 2.5, difference upon original value into 100. 100 by 2.5 is 40%, right? Suppose D, if ratio is 15:13, all right? This is CI, this is SI. Okay? For 2 years, same question. So now what will be the rate? Let's calculate it. So if I have simple interest, 2 years is 30, that means first year, it will be half of 30, 6.5. Second year, it will be remaining 6.5. Because it is going to be the same, right? Compound interest, first year will be same as simple interest, so 6.5. Total 2 year compound interest is 15, so it will be, second year compound interest will be 15 - 6.5, which is 8.5. Whatever is the percentage change from 6.5 to 8.5 is the rate. So value change is 2, divide by original value 6.5 into 100. Now 2 by 6.5, if you simplify, it is 2000 divided by 65. So we have removed the decimal, 10 extra will come. Cancel by 5, so it is 400/13. If you simplify, it will come out to be 30.8 approximately. 30.8%. Alright, so these are some really beautiful questions. Now let's take a couple of more questions and then we'll close the session. Now let's take this question. It says the compound interest on a certain sum for 2 years at the rate 12.5% is 425. Find simple interest on the same sum for the same period, all right, at the same rate. Now, how do we go about this question? Let's see. We still follow the same table. We have other methods also, but I'll give you this shorter method. First year, second year. If I assume the simple interest for the first year as X, second year will also be X, right? And then if I assume the compound interest, we have already taken simple interest as X for the first year. So for the first year, compound interest will also be X because they have to be the same. And the second year compound interest will be X plus 12.5% of X. Why? Because the compound interest increases at the same rate. Right? This is one beautiful situation. Now we know that 25% in terms of fraction is 1 by 4. 50% is 1 by 2. 12.5% is 1 by 8. You have to memorize this. So the benefit here will be, it will become X plus 1 by 8X, which is 9 by 8X. So first year compound interest X, second year compound interest 9 by 8X. Now what happens? Total 2 years compound interest, 2 years compound interest will be equal to X plus 9 by 8X. And in the question, it is given 2 years compound interest is 425. So we have 425 equal to 8 LCM. So it is 8X plus 9X. So this gives us 425 equal to 17X upon 8. So X is equal to 425 into 8 upon 17. Just simplify in a simple manner. 17 cancels 425 directly. 17 twos are 34. 85. So it is 5 times. So 25 into 8 is 200. So X is 200. And remember, what will be the simple interest for 2 years? Simple interest for 2 years. Simple interest for 2 years has to be 2x. So it is 2 into 200, that is 400. So this way, all the questions are really, really easy. You don't have to go back and calculate principal amount. That's the best part about this process, right? The other method would be to calculate principal amount and then to calculate simple interest. But that is not necessary because we know the relation between simple interest and compound interest. For the first year, they are same. For the second year, the compound interest just increases by r percent, right? So using this, this can be done really easily. All right. So I think we have covered all different aspects and topics of this chapter. What you need to do is, if it is possible, repeat the entire theory video once again, then go to the exercise given in the book, and then go to the class exercise. All right. Thank you so much. God bless you. Take care.